overdose of water, new mass of water, boo, boo, pow.
Good everyone, hope everyone's doing well, staying safe. This is Erden.
I am A from AK Chefs. I do live cops. First, like to thank Erden's Kitchen for this opportunity. I'm very grateful that I have the chance to be on his channel.
What's going on, people? My name is Josh, aka the Lucky Botter.
Hello, my name's Saeed. I understand these other guys obviously do really good live cops, tutorials, etc. On my channel, not so much live cops, but definitely more tutorials and information about reselling, botting, etc. I understand this video is basically about community and sort of issuing our gratitude for what the community has done for us this year.
I just wanted to have all of us gather together and want to say a few words of our gratitude towards the community. All the support we've been getting from this year and from you guys have been absolutely awesome for all of us. During this year, a lot of things have gone down that wasn't in our plan. Like for me, I was supposed to have my wedding this year. I was supposed to go on honeymoon with my wife this year. We were supposed to travel a lot more for work and for pleasure, but unfortunately everything got put on hold. And for me, that just made me really anxious at home. And one of the ways for me to have an outlet is to actually use my YouTube channel and to talk about some of the things I've been doing. And for me, it became sneaker botting. Originally, my channel was about cooking. I was actually uploading some of my cooking videos, legit, literal cooking videos on YouTube. And that wasn't getting a lot of traction, but started with the Takashi Murakami COVID-19 box logo tees on Supreme. That's where I started my live cop journey and I loved it. I think I've gotten a ton of support from different people in the community and I was able to get a couple of sponsors. Just, it felt really, it's like a getaway for me when I started doing my videos, doing my recordings and editing videos. And just on Discord, talking with other people, seeing their success, seeing their failures, their frustrations, we talk it out, we help each other out. The camaraderie within the community is definitely something that I felt is the highlight of my year this year.
And I started my channel this year. I am in college and I would have started the channel last year, but I was unable to with everything going on, but at least we were able to make one. Hopefully my live cops are able to help you sort of learn what to do. I'm grateful and thankful to everybody who has watched my channel. They've even found my channel. We try to help as many people as we can. We being AK Chefs and me as well. So I know 2020 has been bad for the most part. And some of it has been good. Hopefully for you, most of it has been good. I don't know if you use any of our videos as outlets or whatever, but I hope they do make you laugh. I hope they do make you smile. I hope you enjoy every second of them.
Back in April, as you know, COVID hit every single part of the world. In London, we closed down all of our businesses, including my day job. This meant I had a lot of time to basically do what I wanted with it. And I needed something. I needed an outlet so that I didn't get bored. I didn't get frustrated. So I chose botting as something to learn over that time. I'd had a bot for around 4 months before that, but I'd never really run it correctly because of my day job and because of how busy I was in my normal life. Well, this is where sneaker botting, Discord groups, etc. came in. And at the same time, I thought, why not just start a YouTube channel? Because no one else in the UK was doing a good production or a good level of YouTube that helped people trying to get into it or helped people like me that was trying to bot with a day job. Now, because of you guys, that YouTube channel's reached 12,000 subscribers. I never would have imagined even reaching 100, let alone 12,000. So I wanted to jump on Erden's video to say a massive thank you to you guys and a massive thank you to Erden, because this is such a good idea, to say Happy New Year to you all and to say a big thank you from all the YouTubers out there that's benefiting from your support.
So obviously been a tough year with COVID, as I'm sure a few of my reselling colleagues have already discussed, but there's been a silver lining. And I think with a lot of people having had time off work or unfortunately lost their jobs, etc., it has given a huge number of people opportunities within the sort of reselling field, especially more recently with things like PlayStations, etc., to have a crack at alternative income sources. And for this reason, we've just seen the community grow. I mean, I own two English speaking groups, one of which is more like novice based, one of which is more experience based, and I own a Chinese speaking group. And within those three groups, we've just seen general growth. It's been really good. And we've seen a lot of people eager to learn how to start botting, how to get into reselling, and sort of where to go from there and sort of increase their additional revenue streams, which is fantastic to see. So yeah, just a huge thank you to the community, really, who have allowed all this to be possible, and for allowing us to continue to grow. And in return, we can hopefully provide you with some content which you find useful. I understand.
My favorite shoe of the year is absolutely bar none, the Strange Love Dunks. Now, this year has been the year of dunks, right? Nike has done a tremendous job on figuring out the dunk market and having different collaborations with different artists, different designers, different companies on dunks. And this year, the Strange Love Dunks definitely knocked it out of the park. When it comes to the design of it, the material they used to make the shoe, the limited release, the hype behind it, and also just the colorway, absolutely gorgeous of a shoe. And if you were able to get a Strange Love Dunk, or if you were able to get one with a special box with it, oh my goodness, that shoe is just gorgeous. I don't have it in my collection and I really want it. So that's my favorite shoe of the year.
So moving on to what I think sneaker of the year is, or my sneakers of the year. Of course, as Erden says, it is year of the dunk. I could have easily have said my Travis Scott's up on there, but actually my favorite dunk that came this year has got to be the Elephant Dunks that came out, I think, what, 2 months ago? Now, a lot of people had some issues with quality control and the elephant print. In all honesty, I don't care about that sort of thing. As you can see, I actually wear my shoes. Most of the stuff that I get is because I'm a collector myself. And I think these were one of the best colorways that came out this year. So clean, and that Tiffany type tick is what I like to call it, I think just sets it apart. So that's my favorite dunk. But, and I might be cheating here, my actual favorite pair that I botted this year has got to be the Sean Wotherspoon Asics. And that's just because of the story behind it and actually what it stands for. The bottom one is Tokyo at night and the top one is LA at day. And basically it's because of the collab between Atmos in Japan and Round 2 over in LA. And I think these are one of my favorite pairs, the corduroy, the colors, just the out there presence of them. I think they're amazing. And of course, Asics are an old school brand. I'm an old guy. So it was something that I was really, really hyped to hit. It was a very hard drop. I think it was the only time I was ever able to hit Slam Jam. And since then I haven't been able to because they've a backdoor or they've gone to raffles. Anyway, not the most hyped of pairs, I know, but they're pairs that I'm really hyped to have in my collection and really pleased to wear on a daily basis.
So I'm supposed to be talking about one of my favorite shoes. I almost would agree with Erden with the Strange Love, but unfortunately I hit a bunch of them on Strange Love's website for the special box and they canceled the entire release and I never got a single one. So that site sits doesn't sit well with me, unfortunately, that shoe. I'd have to go with the Pigeon SBs. I even sort of have a cool story of how I got these. I didn't get them the typical way of even botting or anything. I got them straight from Jeff Staples. He was able to send me a couple of pairs. We looped it and yeah, I was able to get a special box, a normal pair, and a sample one of one pair. And really like how those shoes look. They're nice and simple. And yeah.
Thank you again to Erden for giving me the opportunity to jump in on this segment video, and I wish everyone the best for 2021. If you haven't checked out my channel yet, feel free to do so. I'm sure Erden will stick a link in the description or something. But yeah, once again, thank you for everything, guys, and all the best for 2021.
Yeah, looking forward to 2021. A lot of big plans and yeah, a lot of more shoe drops coming up. So you have a lot more to look forward to. And thank you for everything that you do.
This year overall has been really tough on all of us with the pandemic going on. And with it being a really shit show of a year, what we've gone through and just have so many up and coming young and aspiring YouTubers to come up and follow Bottle Boy Noah's footsteps to do live cops, to talk about sneaker botting, to talk about sneaker reselling. It's just absolutely awesome to see. We want to take this time to show our gratitude. So I just really want to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you all so much for your support. And if it wasn't for you guys, we would not be doing what we do.
So again, a massive thank you to every single one out there. I hope you have a really good new year. Thank you so much for allowing me to have your attention. And of course, as always, be lucky.